Hello and welcome back to weekly test paper 6. Have you watched the videos on unit fractions and proper fraction of a whole number? If not, I highly recommend checking them out. They will be helpful for today's test and your upcoming final exams. If you want to skip the explanation and go straight to the test, you can see the timestamp. In this test, we'll cover square roots of decimal numbers and word problems involving long division and multiplication. Before we begin, let's go over a quick explanation of square roots of decimal numbers and the key rules of square roots. Steps to calculate square roots of decimals. Find square root of 0.64. Step 1. Convert the decimal to a fraction. That is 0.64 is equal to 64/100. In step 2, find the square root of the fraction. So square root of 64/100 is equal to square root of 64/100, which is equal to 8/10, which is equal to 0.8. And in step 3, verify by squaring the result. So 0.8 times 0.8 is equal to 0.64. Now here are the rules of square roots. Every positive number has two square roots, one positive and one negative. For example, both 3 and minus 3 are square roots of 9. Why? Because minus 3 times minus 3 is 9 and 3 times 3 is also 9. Now the second rule is square root of 0 is 0 because 0 times 0 is 0. Multiplication property of square roots. The square root of a product is equal to the product of the square roots. For example, square root of 9 times 4 is same as square root of 9 times square root of 4, which is equal to 3 times 2, because square root of 9 is 3 and square root of 4 is 2, which is equal to 6. It is same as square root of 36. Quotient rule of square roots. Square root of a by b is same as square root of a by square root of b if b not equal to 0. Next rule, decimal and fractions. The square root of a decimal or fraction follows the same rules. Now we'll take one more example. Find square root of 0.09. As we have done before, first of all, convert this to a fraction. So 0.09 is same as 9/100. And then you have to take the square root of the fraction. Square root of 9/100 is same as square root of 9/100, which is equal to 3/10, which is equal to 0.3. Now you can verify your answer by doing 0.3 times 0.3 is equal to 0.09. Now that we have covered square roots and the rules with example, it's time to put your understanding to the test. In this week's test, you will solve problems on square roots of decimal numbers, word problems using long division and multiplication. Make sure to read each question carefully and apply what you have learned. Here is your weekly test paper 6. The instructions are same as before. Marks are out of 20. Pause the video and answer. You also note the time taken. Section A, based on fractions and factors. Section B, word problems. And section C is square root and number puzzle. Here are solutions to paper 5. You can pause the video and check your answers. Solutions to section B and section C. Here are the answers to question 6. In question C, it is square root of 121 divided by 11 and not square root of 11. So the answer is 1. If you have done with square root of 11 as denominator, the answer is square root of 11. For the next test, we'll be focusing on fractions. To prepare, make sure to go through the fraction learning series starting from types of fractions. If there is any specific topic you would like me to explain or a test you would like on a particular concept, let me know in the comments. I would like to hear your suggestions. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe to my channel. All the best for your upcoming exams.